Now those who were scattered because of persecution that took place over Stephen traveled as far as Phoenicia, Cyprus, and Antioch, and they spoke the word to no one except Jews. But among them were some men of Cyprus and Cyrene who, on coming to Antioch, spoke to the Hellenists, proclaiming the Lord Jesus. The hand of the Lord was with them, and a great number became believers and turned to the Lord. News of this came to the ears of church in Jerusalem, and they sent Barnabas to Antioch. When he came and saw the grace of God, he rejoiced, and he exhorted them all to remain faithful to the Lord with steadfast devotion, for he was a good man, full of the Holy Spirit and of faith. And great many people were brought to the Lord. Then Barnabas went to Tarsus to look for Saul, and when he had found him, he brought him to Antioch. So it was then for an entire year they met with the church and brought a great many people. And it was in Antioch that the disciples were first called Christians. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
On Christmas or last month, all your nations praise the Lord.
All your nations praise the Lord.
For the holy month stands the city of in the Lord founded. The Lord loves the people of Zion more than all the dwellings of Jacob. Glorious things are spoken of you, O city of God, whose bounds
all ye nations praise the Lord.
Among those who know me, I mention Rahab and Babylon, Philistia to entire Ethiopia. This one was born there, they say, and Zion it shall be. It shall be said, this one and that one were born in you, for the Most High Himself will establish it. Response.
Holy nations, praise to the Lord.
The Lord records as he registers the people. This one was born there. Singers and dancers alike say, all my strengths are in me. Response.
Holy nations, praise to the Lord.
Am I hearing the voice of the shepherd? What is the voice that leads me in my day. So that will come down to whether or not we're taking time to pray and read scripture each day. What leads my voice? Is it gossip? Is it the news? What is the thing that informs me? And when we are not being led by the shepherd, we find ourselves a lot more judgmental, a lot more worldly. Where God is calling us into this perfect attunement to the shepherd, to get our marching orders from him. And we get that because we ask for it. Lord, I want to hear your voice today. Lord, open my ears. Do not give me a rebellious heart or a stiff neck. And I will not turn. And I will not be changed. Let me be supple. Let me listen to you. I don't know if you've ever had the opportunity to ride a stiff neck horse, but it's quite exciting because the horse doesn't go where you point it. I rode this horse one time that had a big, huge neck on it. I couldn't turn its head. And the horse ended up bucking me off because I couldn't get it to go. And that's kind of what's going to happen with us in Jesus. If we don't have a neck that's going to turn to the way that the Lord is calling us, we're going to walk Jesus off, and we're going to accept another rider for today. So this is what we want. We want that subtle heart, that heart that's open to the grace of God, the heart that wants to turn and listen to the shepherd. Dear brothers and sisters, filled with paschal joy, let us pray more earnestly to God that he will graciously listen to the prayers and supplications of his beloved Son, may now be pleased to look upon us in our lowliness. We pray for our Holy Father Francis, for Pope Emeritus Benedict, for our Bishop Joseph, for their health, intentions, and constant growth in faith, hope, and charity. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
and serve him well as St. Barnabas did for this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray for a greater devotion to the Blessed Virgin Mary, for this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
This Mass we pray in a special way for Father Ron Thompson on his anniversary of ordination. That God may keep him faithful and help him to serve the Lord as a good shepherd, for this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who are sick and suffering, those shut in, those that are in quarantine, those who are dying. They may have the grace to turn to the Lord and truly profit from this time, for this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Moment of silence to offer our own prayers and petitions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all the holy souls in purgatory, and we ask them to join us with the saints and angels in heaven, especially our Blessed Mother, St. Joseph, to pray for more of our patients to the priesthood, to the consecrated life of the holy matrimony, to preserve all those in their vocations, and assist us in our universal call of holiness. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, who knows that our life in this present age is subject to suffering and need, hear the desires of those who cry to you and receive the prayers of those who believe. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread of God, the fruit of the earth, and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine and offering, through the vine and work of human hands, who will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Thank you.
Holy Spirit, all glory and honor
spiritual communion, my Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were.